Happy Thursday, Oakwood Kinders. Not much work with story time today. I'm just going to show you these et family words. Remember, since they all end in et, they all rhyme. So we're just going to go ahead and read them. See how fast we can read them, okay? So I'm going to let you look at them first. Remember, the only thing that's changing is the beginning sound in a rhyming word or a word family, right? So it's always going to have the et sound, so b-et, right? And the only thing that's changing is the first sound. So ready? Let's see how fast we can do them. Ready? Bet, jet, pet, set, yet, let, wet, get. Very good. Can we go faster on this set? Oh, that's four times. We're just going to do it three times. Ready? Let's see if we can go a little faster. Ready? I'm going to do it by, you're by yourself this time. Oh, I mixed them up there. And super fast this time, all by yourself. Ready? Good job. My math lesson was pretty long, so I'm just going to do a little review. And now it is time for the Golden Egg Book. Now, it's not really an Easter book, and that's okay, but it does have an egg in it. And it was my very favorite story when I was your age, and I gave it to my daughter when she was about your age. I have two daughters. I gave it to my younger daughter. And my older daughter, Kelsey, I'm in her bed today because I told you I love to read in bed. And these, her favorite animal are elephants. So I have all of her elephants because an elephant makes an appearance in this book. In an egg book, pretty strange, but anyways, this is the Golden Egg Book. And it was my favorite. It is by Margaret Wise Brown and illustrated by Leonard Weisgard. It's a very old book. It was around before I was little, so I'm not that old. I'm not as old as the book, even though I'm kind of old, right? All right, see? That's the title page. And there's the bunny. It's like I said, even though it's not about Easter, it has eggs and it has a bunny and an elephant. All right. I love the pictures in this book. Once there was a little bunny. He was all alone. One day he found an egg. He could hear something moving inside the egg. What was it? Maybe a little boy, you think? Maybe another bunny? Maybe an elephant? Maybe a mouse? Do you think they would be inside that egg? No, all of those are mammals. And they're born alive and well. They don't hatch from an egg. But maybe the bunny doesn't know that. Who could tell what he would find? And how would a little bunny know? But there was something inside that egg. He could hear something moving. He shook it. Then the bunny pushed the egg with his foot. He jumped on top of the egg. He climbed a tree and threw nuts at it. My goodness, he really wants it to come out, but whatever's inside, I don't think that's very nice. He rolled the egg down a hill, but still it didn't break, and whatever was in the egg didn't come out. It's probably not ready yet, silly bunny. So the bunny threw a rock at the egg, but because he was only a little bunny, it was a very little rock, and he didn't throw it very hard, and the egg didn't break. Well, that's good. I'm glad to hear that. I know he just wants a friend, but that's not very nice to treat something you don't even know what's inside. And can something come out of an egg before it's ready? No. to get out of that egg. The bunny sat very still and watched through his shining eyes. He sat very still and listened with his big, soft ears. Pick, pick, pick. I would like to have bunny ears. You could hear a lot with those bunny ears. Then the little bunny began to yawn. And he yawned and he yawned. The egg was very quiet. He curled up all sleepy and warm close to the egg and went to sleep. He went to sleep because he was so sleepy. Then, dot, dot, dot. What do you think is going to happen? Make a prediction. Oh, what do you think? Tell me. You think something's going to come out of the egg? What do you think it is? What comes out of an egg? Oh, good thinking. Let's see if you're right. Pick, 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 and peck, 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 and crackety crack. Out jumped a little yellow duck. Well, what is this? Said the little duck when he saw the bunny. What could this little fur thing be? Oh, that sounds familiar. The bunny was very sleepy, so he was still asleep and didn't wake up. Inside the egg, said the duck, I thought I was all alone in a small dark world. Now I find myself alone with a bunny in a big bright world, and the bunny won't wake up. Thumbs up or thumbs down? Do you think he's going to try to wake him up? Oh, most of you say thumbs up. How do you think he's going to wake him up? Tell me on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Oh, good thinking. I like the way your brain's working today. Let's see if you're right. So the duck pushed the bunny with his foot. That sounds familiar. And jumped on top of him. And threw a little rock at him. And rolled him down a hill. Just like the bunny did to him, huh? And the bunny woke up. Where is my egg? Said the bunny. And where did you come from? Never mind that, said the duck. Here I am. So the bunny and the duck were friends, and no one was ever alone again. T-H-E-E-N-D, the end, end, end. Ooh, do you see any insects on this page? I know you've been working with Miss Penny. Do you see any insects? Ooh, I see a couple butterflies. Do you see anything else? All right. T-H-E-E-N-D, the end, end, end. Oh, excuse me. All right, that is one of Mrs. Gibbs' all-time favorite books, and definitely my favorite book when I was your age. I fell down and I hit my head really, really hard. I had what you call a concussion, and the doctor didn't want me to sleep. And so this was one of the books that my family read me over and over again. And I think it's perfect, even though it's not an Easter book, because it has a bunny and an egg and a chick. So that's my story. Have a great rest of your day. Bye-bye, boys and girls. See you tomorrow.